Hey guys, it's John. You are on the JRB Tree Climbing Channel, and you're on the playlist, The JRB Climbing Method. I am every bit of 30 feet up in a walnut tree. We had a tornado blow through last week, and so there's been some casualties, but I'm on a safe crotch in a safe tree. And I want to give you a little bird's eye view of my system from the canopy, and then transition into rappel mode and have you see how I attach that Munter friction hitch. So first you're seeing my redundant bridge here, and this is my rappel device. This is my carabiner, my triple locking carabiner, which will be used for rappel. Now note, I can't drop this because it is fixed on my redundant bridge. I even have a little cable tie on there to make sure it doesn't ever go anywhere. Now this bridge really only takes load during rappel or an emergency, so I don't really need it to slide back and forth as freely as I do my main bridge. Still attached is my garter hitch foot loop, and down below you'll see my feet are in the stirrups. Now I'm going to pan north in the system, and you'll see my swivel. That's a pronged swivel, another Gridlock Magnetron triple action beaner, a pair of double Mishicon. I just published that knot, and or that assembly of knots, I should say, and I'm climbing with them on the JRB system, and the crotch is a little higher up. I've thrown every bit of 40 feet to get to this this location. And when I transition into rappel, I'll be reaching up here and breaking these. And it's quite easy to do, but you won't be watching that. You'll be watching the Munter, and I'll just describe that. And I'm going to bring them from roughly this point to roughly this point, so they're nice and slack, and that's where I'll be tending them with one hand. Okay, so I am going to fix my camera to my chest. Bear with me. And the first step in the rappel operation is to remove the garter hitch. So bring some slack in. Now, I could stuff this in my saddlebag, but it's already attached to my redundant bridge, so I'm just gonna leave it there. It's not gonna affect the operation of the Munter. Okay, I'll bring these lines into view, and there's no twists in them. And in order to ensure that no twists are imparted as we engage the Munter, I'll take the right strand and move it over the left one. Why do I do that? Because when we start to form the Munter with an underhand loop to the left, those strands will come right back where they were. Okay? So that's why I have that one turn. Turn it back, and I have an underhand turn to the left. That's the first part of forming the Munter, and then hang these lines down. So that is your standard Munter. You clip in your beaner like such. It's got both lines. I'll bring the slack out of it. Now, in order to neutralize any spin, what I've learned is if you flip this up, and I'll have my hand right about here managing slack, I will neutralize spin going into the Munter. So now I'm going to reach up with my right hand, and I'm going to break each of the friction hitches one at a time. When I do that, I'll kind of saunter a little to the left and a little to the right as the system moves in the crotch. So I'm breaking the one on the right, and it is now loose and slack. Okay, and now I'm going to break the one on the left. And I've worked those so they're nice and slack. Let me get my primary bridge out of the way so you can keep your eye on that Munter. And so now all I do is manage slack, and there's no spin. You would feel spin if it was going into the rope, and there is none. Now I'm going to stop and let the system grab again. Now let's say you've got a different weight profile than me. You weigh more, and therefore you need additional friction. Well, it's easy to take this Munter and transform it into what they call a super Munter or a monster Munter. And so I will start over and form that. Okay, so I'll take those two lines, half turn to the left, start by forming my Munter. So we've got some options here. I'm going to get that garter hitch out of the way. Okay. We've got some options here. One thing I like to do to prepare to engage additional friction is take these two lines and put them up and over the top. And so now I'm set to form a super munter or a monster munter, and that will be formed by bringing this line in here. But just by doing that, we also impart just some additional friction. So this is another incremental step to add some friction, but not quite as much as the monster. I'll break my friction hitches. This time I broke them both at the same time. Get this out of the field of view. You get the idea. All right, so now I'll let my friction hitches catch. And I'm going to form the full monster munter. And that's simply by taking this line in like that. Now, if you were using non-triple action beaners, you might want to reorient your beaner so the gate is on the other side. But I've got triple action. So this is going to impart even more friction. So I'll go ahead and break my friction hitches. I might take you out of the field of view while I do that. And now I've got so much friction that, you know, I have to feed slack in. So this is a little too much friction for me and my body weight. But if you weigh more, you might need it. Okay, there you have it. The Munter friction hitch and its variants and how to set them for rappel in the JRB climbing system.